So you do this one too, huh? It's fantastic.
Yeah, I haven't done it in a while, though.
I mean, I know it's pronounced Rolling Stones and not Rolling Stone-A's, so... You know?
Hey, look! The guys are here.
Oh, man.
They've been waiting on us all right. This time. Tea with the lads!
Hey.
Thank you so much for coming. Cheers, Adam.
Cheers, Liz. Check it out. We're here during the day. You can probably actually see some daylight peeking in from behind us. I don't think we've recorded yet in the afternoon.
We have not.
But there's more importantly...
There's something strange going on.
Right? The whole thing is just cattywampus. Some beautiful changes. We're recording during the day, and do we have some delicious tea?
We have some new tea. Not anymore, but used to be a proud Belfast tea, this. And now made by Thompson's.
Check it out.
It's Punjana.
This was gifted to us by a loyal and faithful viewer. Thank you so much, Charlie Lord, for this.
Thank you.
Amazing. Thanks
for
watching.
It's a great cup of tea, man.
Charlie's a Belfast man.
Where all the good-looking ones come from.
So thanks, Charlie.
Yeah,
cheers for that.
Yeah, appreciate that. We actually haven't heard from many of you about what your favorite teas and stuff are.
If you haven't.
As you know, Lion's Tea is an absolute favorite of Adam's. And mine is, I'm a go-to Nambari guy. Punjana I've had, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I might have bought it at the Irish Fair.
Oh, fantastic. I wasn't aware that it was there, but I'll look for it this year.
I think I didn't see him this year. Okay. Maybe I just missed him for some reason, but there's a guy that sells all the groceries, and I go and load up a little bag of stuff. Although, Amazon's really really handy for this sort of thing, too.
I got McDonald's curry sauce via Amazon today.
Wow.
It is the place where we're all eventually going to shop for 100% of our needs.
So, I mean...
That's not good.
No comments on whether that's a good thing or not.
I'll say it's not a good thing.
Use Amazon.
Oh, yeah.
I use it for a lot of my British stuff. My Branston pickle.
Oh, man.
My HP sauce.
Your fruity HP.
I don't do the
fruity one?
I haven't had that in a while.
That's good.
Do you like that one?
I like that one. I don't put it in my tea.
I get my Bisto from there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In fact, I got an ad on the Amazon page for Bisto when I clicked order my McDonald's curry. Best curry in Ireland.
And I do have my Bisto gravy and my Bisto chip shop curry.
Oh, the chip shop curry is very good.
Yeah,
that's very good.
Hey, last week we were chit-chatting to you all about St. Patrick's Day. And
whew, we're alive.
We're still alive. Adam was actually bragging a little bit ago. How many shows did you play?
Well, over the course of the weekend, we played 5. Over the course of the 3 weeks that comprised our St. Patrick's Day doings, 9.
9 shows.
And I'm still talking right now.
Yeah, that's great.
Which is awesome.
That is great.
Which is awesome.
And you didn't break a string.
I didn't break a single string the entire time. It's a testament to the quality of my buddy Wyatt Overman, who does all my luthery stuff.
Wyatt has gently loved all of these instruments.
This is going to Wyatt tomorrow once we're done filming this.
I didn't break a string, but then I changed my strings for every show.
Yeah, see, I...
Just in case.
I just kind of went, you know what? I want to see how long this is going. I fully intended to change the strings after, like, the second weekend of stuff.
Yeah.
And then I just had too much else going on, and I totally spaced it. And then I just kind of, all right, let's see how long this goes.
We hope you enjoyed last week's episode where we talked about St. Patrick's Day, and we talked about the whiskey in the jar. Whiskey in the jar.
How many times
did you play that? I only played it, I think, the once with Pete McCauley.
Okay.
And even though the Rocket Soul Choir rehearsed it, we ended up not playing it.
Not even doing it.
We were packing up, and Adam said, we didn't play Whiskey in the Jar.
Different went, Adam, not me.
A-T-O-M.
Different spelling, not
yeah,
me.
Yeah, yeah, not you.
We had you covered, though. I think we played it at least 10 times.
Oh, well
done. Yeah.
If you like what we do, you can go and do the subscribe and the like and the sharings and all of that sort of stuff. We love that. We love to hear from you. We'd love to hear from you about tea. We'd love to hear from you. Song suggestions, they're always welcome.
Or Jaffa cakes, McVitie's biscuits.
Chocolate Hobnobs
yes.
are a massive favorite over here at Tea with the Lads HQ. So we can dunk it into our tea. And it really is a fine cup of tea.
Absolutely.
I feel like I always drink my tea too quick when I'm here. I don't know why that is.
Gotta get it done.
I feel like I'm talking a lot. So, you picked today's song.
I did. I did. And it's just sort of an, kind of out of left field kind of thing. But I like the song a lot. I used to play it in a solo show I used to do and haven't done in years. I just thought we would sound good doing it. So I thought, let's try it.
I think we did it as A Little of the Ready.
Did you?
I think so,
remember
yeah.
That band? Yeah.
Okay. I mean, A Little of the Ready is a long, long time ago, but that was a Celtic band that I played in, and I think we did it. We did all sorts of weird covers. Sixpence None the Richer.
Good song is a good song.
Prince.
Sure.
We got it all in there.
Natural set mates.
Set mates for a Celtic pub.
Sure. Right.
But we're going to play for you Gillian?
Gillian? Who knows?
I've always heard it as Gillian. And Adam says that you've always heard it as Gillian. You can tell us. We don't mind one way or the other.
I will fully
She's
admit.
She's lovely.
I'm not very knowledgeable about her or her career. I like the song. Somebody asked me to play it once, and I didn't know it. So I looked it up and learned it because it was a good song.
Oh, it's so beautiful.
So unfortunately, that's the extent of my knowledge.
Her and David Rawlins, and he is such a...
He's the producer guy that does the... and he plays like the slide and stuff.
He plays the slide guitar and just regular guitar, and he has such a wonderful touch. Gillian Welch. All she has to do is just have to play.
Yeah.
Just basically play it the way she sees it, and David just does stuff over the top that just always makes it beautiful. And it's such a neat little unit just to have the two people and two acoustic instruments.
Yeah, they're tight.
I see them quite regularly on the YouTubes just playing around one microphone. Mm-hmm. There's such an intimacy when performers are around one microphone. You have to be conscious of the other person.
Yeah, you're mixing yourself.
Yeah, exactly.
Which is how they used to do it old school before, you know, multi-track recording and all this equipment, various microphones, everything is close mic'd, and they've got a big board and can say, oh, I want a little more of this, a little more of that. It was literally the most rudimentary direct-to-wax record recordings were done around one big microphone, usually a big dark ribbon microphone. And those country acts and the bluegrass acts who kind of started the whole thing really knew how to perform with each other and would literally physically move in and back off when they would solo and sing and things like that. And Gillian does it well.
Yeah, she does.
They play cool vintage instruments as well, so they're really benefiting from those techniques to get the best sound out of the instruments.
Yeah, absolutely. We always kind of come to you, Tea with the Lads comes to you from Adam's studio, working studio here. We always love just recording techniques and microphone techniques.
I love that stuff.
I mean, you will have noticed if you've watched the videos from the beginning, that the audio has changed, hopefully improved.
Yeah, right.
because we've come up with new ideas about how to approach it and how to do it. And
we have an eye to the presentation.
Yeah,
you know, we want to give you the best quality sound and video.
One of the things I remember, there was a band from Scotland. They were from and actually called Abernathy.
I know that name.
And they their first record, they recorded the entire thing live, and they recorded it around one microphone.
Old
and I
school.
Remember all of the studio notes from that, just about where people needed to be.
Mm-hmm.
The mixing happened in the moment.
Live. Yeah.
Well, it happened live, but it also was do a track. Oh, the bass is too loud. Stick it back another 6 inches.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's the way they ended up recording. And I just thought that was beautiful.
Anyway,
exactly.
So we're doing a Gillian Welch song.
So we're going to do Look at Miss Ohio.
This is a great song.
Oh, it's a
Let's
fantastic
it.
Song.
Oh, me, oh, my, oh, look at Miss Ohio. She's running around with the rain top down. She said I want to do right, but not right now. Want to drive to Atlanta. Live out this fantasy, running around with the ragtop down. Yeah, I wanna do right, but not right now. Mm-hmm. Hide your arm around her shoulder, regimental soldier. Mama starts pushing that way down. Yeah, I wanna do right, but not right now. Oh, me, oh my, oh, look at Miss Ohio, running around with the rag top down. She says I wanna do right, but not right now.
Stuff. Thanks for writing that song, man.
Gillian.
Thank you.
Gillian Welch.
Cheers, everybody. Thanks for hanging out with us today. Like, subscribe, share with all of your friends. Tell us about your tea likes, your song likes, all of the stuff. We love the comments. We love interacting.
Absolutely.
We'll see you next time.
Cheers, everybody. See you next time. Thanks.
All right. Sweet.